Good afternoon, children of class 8. Today we'll be doing the chemistry chapter 5, which is called Language of Chemistry. And in this chapter, we would be looking at how we can understand chemistry. We all know that we use abbreviations in every field of study. Abbreviation is a short form of a word or a phrase. Like in English language, etc. is the short form for the word etc. ETC is the short form for the word etc., meaning and the other things it means. Similarly, in chemistry also we use abbreviations, and these are used to represent the names of elements, compounds, and to represent or show reactions. Short forms save time and also makes our learning and understanding quick and easy. So that is why we use short symbols or we use short forms to depict elements or compounds. Now, what is a symbol of an element? It represents the short form of an element. For example, H is a symbol which represents the hydrogen atom. And second thing, what a symbol of an element is, a symbol has qualitative as well as quantitative significance. Now let us understand this, children. What is qualitative significance of a symbol? It means it represents the name of the element. As we took the example of H, which represents the name hydrogen of an element. Then we need to understand what is quantitative representation through a symbol. It represents one atom of an element, like hydrogen represents one atom of an element. And second thing in quantitative understanding is the atomic weight expressed in atomic mass unit is represented. For example, let's take another symbol, the symbol C, which is of carbon. So it shows, symbol C shows an element carbon, which this is the name of an element, and one atom of carbon. C shows it is one atom of carbon and 12 parts by weight of carbon. Or we can say that the atomic mass of one atom of carbon is 12 AMU or 12 atomic mass unit. How should we write down the symbols of elements? The symbols of elements can be written as the first letter of the name is written, which is a symbol written as capital letter. For example, in carbon, we use the first letter of this element. So we give it C. The symbol is C. To represent nitrogen, we use the first letter of nitrogen, which has the symbol N. Likewise, for oxygen, we have the symbol O. In some cases, the symbol of the element has two letters, of which the first letter is capital and the second letter is small. So let us look at these examples. Like in cobalt, we write the symbol as capital C and small O. Then in nickel, we write the symbol as capital N and small I. Then calcium, in the element calcium, we write the symbol, a first letter is taken capital C and then small letter A. So CA represents calcium. In some other cases, the symbol of elements are derived from their Latin names. For example, sodium is derived from natrium. Now, natrium is a Latin word for sodium. Likewise, Kalium is a Latin word for potassium, and so it is symbolized by the letter K, and sodium is symbolized by the letters Na, which are taken from natrium. Now, nowadays, the symbols of elements having atomic number more than 100. So, all those elements which have atomic number, if you remember, children, what was atomic number? Atomic number is the number of protons in the nucleus of the atom of an element. So, the symbols of elements having atomic number more than 100 have three letters, of which first letter is capital. The other two letters are small. Let us see, for example, unilbium. Unilbium, in this we take capital U, the first letter, and then we take the letter N, and then we take the letter B. So there are three letters representing the symbol of unilbium. Now, valency. If we remember what valency is from the last chapter, chapter 4 that we studied of atomic structure, it is the combining capacity of an element. What is valency, children? It is the combining capacity of an element. Now, before we go more into what valency is and how it is utilized, let us look at a list of some of the symbols that are derived from their Latin names. For example, sodium, we saw Na is the symbol and is derived from Latin natrium. Potassium with symbol K is derived from kalium. Iron with symbol Fe derived from ferrum. And copper with symbol Cu derived from cuprum. Silver with symbol Ag derived from argentium. And gold with symbol Au derived from aurum. Mercury with symbol Hg derived from hydrargyrum. And lead with the symbol Pb derived from plumbium. Tin with symbol Sn derived from stannum, and tungsten with symbol W derived from wolfram. So we see that this is how we can make the symbols of certain Latin named elements. Now, coming back to what we said about the valency, it is numerically equal to the number of hydrogen atoms. What is valency? Valency is numerically equal to the number of hydrogen atoms that combine with an element. Every hydrogen atom, if you remember, children, in its outermost shell or the single shell which it has got one electron. So, its valency is one. For example, in methane, we see carbon is there and four hydrogen are there. So, carbon combines with four hydrogen. We see here, carbon combines with this hydrogen, this one and this one. So, four atoms of hydrogen, they combine with carbon. So, carbon's valency is four. What is the valency of carbon? The valency of carbon is four because it combines with four more atoms of hydrogen. And each atom has one electron in its outermost shell. And that is why the valency of carbon is 4. Then we see valency is also numerically equal to the number of chlorine atoms that combine with an atom of that element. We all know that chlorine also has a negative valency of 1 because it has got 7 electrons in its outermost shell. In an atom of chlorine, we have 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So, it has got a negative valency 1. Now, in this, in magnesium chloride, we see that magnesium chloride, two atoms of chlorine combine with magnesium. So its valency is 2. What is the valency of magnesium? It's 2 positive valency, because magnesium combines with 2 chlorine atoms. If you see here, we can show here magnesium. It has got 2 electrons in its outermost shell, and there are 2 chlorines. And these chlorines are having 7 and 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So magnesium transfers 1 electron into each of the chlorine atom. And so how much valency magnesium has? Magnesium has a valency of 2. So the third thing that we see with valencies, it is also equal to double the number of oxygen atoms which it combines. If we see an oxygen atom, then in its outermost shell, oxygen atom has got 6 electrons in its outermost shell. And magnesium, we have already seen, has got 2 electrons in its outermost shell. Now, when magnesium transfers these 2 electrons to the oxygen atom, then oxygen now has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 2 electrons transferred here. So the valency of magnesium is 2. The valency of magnesium here is Mg2+, and of oxygen is O-2. It has got -2 valency. Now, valency of metals and non-metals. Let us come to what is the valency of metals and non-metals. What is valency of metals? Valency of a metal is the number of electrons lost. What is the valency of metal? Valency of a metal is the number of electrons lost by an atom of it during the formation of a compound. That is to complete its octet. For example, valency of potassium is 1 and the valency of magnesium is 2. We saw here that magnesium is ready to lose its 2 electrons. So, when the atom of magnesium loses its 2 electrons, it becomes a positively charged ion or a cation. So, we see the valency of magnesium is 2 and the valency of potassium is 1, because potassium, it has got 1 electron in its outermost shell which it loses. It is ready to lose this 1 electron, so it gains a valency of 1. Now, what is valency of a non-metal? Valency of a non-metal is the number of electrons gained by an atom of it during the formation of a compound. That is to complete its octet or the outermost shell. Like we see, chlorine, it gains 1 electron to complete its octet or the outermost shell. And chlorine gets 8 electrons in its outermost shell to become like its nearest inert gas, argon. Likewise, we see valency of sulfur. Sulfur, it also gains 2 electrons to complete its octet. So we see, what is valency of a non-metal? Valency of a non-metal is the number of electrons gained by an atom of it during the formation of a compound. For example, we saw here that magnesium, it gave 2 electrons to chlorine, and chlorine, which is a non-metal, it took 1 electron each, and so chlorine, it gained an electron. So chlorine, being a non-metal, gained an electron to complete its octet. Now let us see valency of various elements. We see there are various elements, and these various elements, we have monovalent elements. What are elements which are monovalent? They have a valency of one, and that is why they are called monovalent elements. For example, sodium has got valency of one. Likewise, potassium has got valency of one. So these are monovalent elements. Then we have divalent elements, like we saw oxygen, which is divalent. It has got a valency of two. Likewise, we have magnesium, which is also divalent because it has got a valency of two. Likewise, we see there are trivalent elements. For example, nitrogen, which has got a valency of three. So that is why it is nitrogen. It gains three electrons, so it has got a valency of three. Likewise, we have example of phosphorus. So trivalent elements having a valency of three are called trivalent elements. Then we see tetravalent elements. The elements which have a valency of four are known as tetravalent elements. For example, we saw the example of carbon here. Carbon also has got tetravalency, or it has got a valency of four. So it is a tetravalent element. So we see here that valency is very important. And if you look at page number 79 here, we can together, children, recapitulate, or we can revise what we had learned earlier. Zinc has got a symbol written first letter capital Z and then small letter N. So zinc is written as ZN. Likewise, we see that sodium is written as capital N and small a. Oxygen is written with O. Potassium is written with K. Nitrogen we represent by the symbol N. Calcium we represent by capital C and small a as the symbol. Uranium we represent by U, and cobalt we represent by CO. Radium we represent by R and A, and argon we represent by capital A and R. Lead we represent by capital B and capital P and small b. Lead, it is taken from plumbium, so it is Pb. Mercury we represent as Hg, capital H and small g. Iron we represent as capital F and small e. It is taken from ferrum, Latin word ferrum. Then iodine we represent by the symbol I, and gold we represent by the symbol Au, because it is, this symbol is taken from aurum, which is the Latin name of this element. So children, hope you understood this video. Watch it several times to make it more clear. So I'll be sending you the assignments for this soon. Wish you all the best. Thank you.